You compare what it's like to listen with a cochlear implant, it's not totally natural, but you compare it to deafness and it's absolutely amazing. I was been at the forefront of cochlear implants since cochlear implants first came out. We didn't do the first cochlear implant, but very early on, I was been at the forefront. Bruce Gantz, you know, did the first multi-channel implant, did the first congenitally deaf kid. There's a lot of firsts at Iowa. Early cochlear implants, we were happy if they could hear a sound. And then the early multi-channel electrodes, people were getting maybe 20% word understanding, you know, better than being deaf, but not great. But nowadays, reliably, you're gonna get 70% words, and our good performers, if we get in the ear and we're able to save the structures and everything works out, then they're upwards of, you know, high 80s, 90% word understanding. The technology's improved, coding strategies of how to encode speech in a digital way across some electrodes, that's changed. And then just the health of the ear that we're putting these electrodes in, we put them in much healthier ears so they work better. You know, there's a lot that's gonna happen in the future. Originally, it was just a profoundly deaf ear. Now we go into healthy ears. We combine the electrical stimulation with the implant with their natural acoustic hearing. That makes a huge difference, not only for hearing electrically, but especially for like listening to music or listening to background noises, how rapidly the brain can process sound, how well it processes speech sounds. All of that is enhanced by preserving the natural low frequency hearing, and the University of Iowa has been one of the major forces in the world behind that sort of development. Even now, like most technology, a lot of the technology, the new electrodes, drug eluting, we're one of the first centers in the world that usually get our hands on this stuff, and we're usually involved in the trials. It's a privilege, it's a blessing to be able to help these people and to be a small part of it. I think it's hard for us to see what life was like without hearing, but it's really hard. And then to be able to go to work, go to school, listening to music, or to interact with your family around the dinner table, it's life-changing.